such miserable levels on the TDC that we just, it's weird to say thank you to someone all of a sudden. And this is a big problem for our city, right? Like, commuting is a hot button issue. We all feel it, and we all feel the pain. And we often talk about it from the perspective of how do we get better routes and more service. But we don't ever talk about it from the perspective of how do we create more joy. And I think joy is really important because as citizens, we have that agency to create it. If we want to live in a great city, it is up to all of us to do that. And often I feel that so many of the solutions that are out there are out of our hands. Well, Project Ukulele is a little bit, ukulele gangsterism is a little bit different. And I thought to myself, you know, one day, you know, what would happen if we just got someone smiling a little bit more on the subway? How would that change the day? How would that change the social fabric of our city and create a ripple effect whether you're on your way to work or school or play? So this idea of encouraging people to smile and bringing joy on the subway became a big thing that I became obsessed with. I was also told that if you put a smiling baby in your presentation, your appreciation level goes up like 10%. That's why it's there. So anyways, you know, there's this real idea about bringing joy to the subway. So this idea for a Project Ukulele Gangsterism was born. And I can tell you right now, I'm actually not really a proficient ukulele player, but I do love the instrument. And I thought to myself, wouldn't it be neat if a bunch of strangers got on the subway one day and played a song together? What if we get 10 people to play surprise ukulele concerts? So I took this idea to the Awesome Foundation. And for those of you who are familiar with the Awesome Foundation is a citizen organized group that provides grants of $1,000 to citizens who have awesome ideas. And they give that money in cash. It's a really nice moment. You'll see a picture of me in a second with this massive smile on my face. And the Awesome Foundation, you see there's the cash. The Awesome Foundation has several chapters in the world. And there's actually two in Toronto, to the best of my knowledge. One is Awesome Toronto, and the other is Awesome CSI. And CSI, for those of you who are not familiar, stands for the Center for Social Innovation. And CSI is a shared workspace that has now three locations in the city. And so the big question that they asked me is, why the ukulele? And the answer is quite simple. The ukulele is the most accessible instrument. It is easy to learn. It is cheap. So it's very affordable. And it's very portable. And you may or may not know this, but there's actually a ukulele movement happening globally. There are meetups like the Corktown Ukulele Jam that exists on the east end of the city. And at the Rooster, there's another ukulele jam, and there's stuff happening on the west end. I just came from Steve's today, and they said that they're selling on average of 50 ukuleles a day in peak periods. And so it's not surprising there's this ukulele movement because people are digging the sound. And I think most of all, it's hard to sound harsh on the ukulele. So we got the money, and the next thing was, let's form a gang. And so we put the call out to the community, and we thought it would be really neat if we got maybe 10 people to come out. As of today, our gang is nearly 50 people strong. And what's really fascinating about that is actually most of those people have never played the ukulele before. They just kind of believe in the idea and what we're trying to do. And it's funny, now I've developed a reputation. People will call me or message me and tell me all these ukulele-related things that happen in the city. Someone will tell me, I just saw someone on the streetcar playing the ukulele. I think they're playing our song. Or as in this picture, you know, someone will post a picture saying, I woke up in bed this morning and started playing my ukulele. And really sweet things. And there's this real idea that playing the ukulele together is something meaningful. So the big question now for us is, you know, how we're actually taking this group out there. And we've been really fortunate to have a good degree of publicity. This is a picture of me with Matt Galloway on Metro Morning from a few weeks ago. My new claim to fame is that I made him giggle. Apparently this was harder said than done. And, you know, we've been featured in a number of other publications. And the big question that people have asked is, why has PUG taken off the way it has? And there's really three simple answers to that. One, I think the name is killer, and I can say that because I didn't come up with it. Two, there's this whole thing that we all understand the shared problem about it, right? Like we all get that commuting is a miserable activity. And three, I think, is that, you know, this is a project about joy. We have no prerogative. We're not. We have no marketing ambitions. We're not collecting money. We're just doing it to be nice to people. And so there's something kind of special about that. So we are, I'm very excited to announce, we are taking the subways tomorrow morning at 7:30. And we've been doing a bunch of research, and so to give you the lowdown, at 7:30 in the morning, 45 ukulele gangsters are going to be in the Spadina station and hit up the platform. Hit up the platform and hit up the other platform and take the eastbound train across to Yonge. And we're really, really excited about it. It's going to be chaotic. It's going to be a lot of fun things. And if you are there, we would love to see you. And if you're not, either way, I wish you an awesome day. Thank you.